Today we're going to test the new Sony Xperia XZ, which received an IP rating of 68, meaning that it's capable of withstanding water in approximately 1 meter, a bit more, in maybe 30 minutes. So we're going to test it by dropping it into the ocean and seeing how much pressure it will take before it eventually breaks. So we've come up with this device where we're going to mount the phone. Using a GoPro camera, we'll have some footage from under the water as well. And then we're going to lower it at first to 1 meter, after that 2 meters, 3 meters, and it will stay at each point of depth at about 5 minutes, then we'll take it back up, test how the speakers work, test how the phone works in general, and then we'll try another depth until it collapses. So, now the Sony Xperia XZ have spent approximately 5 minutes in the ocean, so we're going to pull it up and see if everything still works. Seems something's happened, but the touch and screen, everything works perfectly. Works fine, just a bit of water coming in contact with it. Now for the music. The speakers and everything works just fine. So, after the first successful attempt, we are now going to lower the Sony to 3 meters instead of one, and again, keep it there for 5 minutes, pull it back up, and see how everything is still functioning. Okay? So, now the Sony has spent 5 minutes approximately underwater, and we're going to pull it up to see if everything still works. Everything seems to look just fine. Touchscreen is reacting perfectly. We can even hear the music and the speakers working just fine. We're going to test if the 5 meters can break the phone. So, let's see how it goes. So, now the Sony Xperia XZ have spent 5 minutes under 5 meters of water. So we'll try to pull it up and see how it stands tall. When we pull it up at first, it seems like the screen definitely survived. The screen and touch, everything is working just fine. Check again for the music. We still have working speakers as well. This is quite impressive. 7 meters for 5 minutes to see if it can still hold up. So, now the Sony Xperia XZ have spent 5 minutes under 7 meters of water, so we're going to check if it's still durable and still works as before. And yes, still as the other test, it's reacting just fine. It's working perfectly. We can try to test the speakers and the music. And yeah, everything's working. Even the speakers are playing just as before. We're going to try to put it down to 10 meters for 5 minutes. So, now the Sony Xperia XZ have spent 5 minutes 10 meters underwater, and we're going to pull it up to see if it is still alive. So, at first glance it actually looks like we still might have a working phone. Let's try and pull it all the way up so that we can check. We might have said that too early. I just think the screen turned off, but let's try to check it out anyway. At the moment we have, for the first time, we have a black locked or dead screen, I'm not sure yet. There is some kind of reaction. We don't have a working phone. anymore, it seems. I can see the time and everything, but the brightness is all the way down, the apps and all the program is jumping around, and at the moment everything is happening at the same time, so the hopes of a working phone for after 5 minutes under 10 meters of water is a bit too much. So yeah, that was it for the Sony Xperia. We're not going to be testing it at 11 or 12 meters at the moment. So, after a couple of minutes while we try to figure out what happened to the Sony, we have to admit now that it's officially dead. We no longer have a working phone. Sometimes we get a little glimpse of light, but it's not durable or working anymore. But to sum it all up, it cleared 1, 3, 5, 7 meters at 5 minutes each. So we can say we are really impressed with the new Sony Xperia XZ, and it actually did really well in the test. So thank you all for watching and have a good day.